Hola, my name is Pamela. Welcome to my channel. Today, I'm gonna talk about Profibus, or Process Field Bus, is a communication standard for field buses. If you want to know more, I will leave you my videos in the eye for you to check. Now, let's get into it. First, it's important to understand that Profibus has evolved over time. Profibus FMS was first created in 1987 in Germany by 21 companies and institutions to create a bit serial field bus system group named as Central Association for the Electrical Industry. Profibus FMS, or Field Bus Message Specification, was designed to communicate between controllers and PCs, sending complex information between them. However, this technology was not as flexible as needed, because this protocol was not suitable for less complex messages or communications in a larger and more complicated network. Although it is still used today, most users prefer the new versions, which I will explain later. A large number of cables were required to implement Profibus FMS, because each instrument was powered independently and had to cover the distance to the control room. Later, Profibus DP, or Decentralized Peripherals, was created to standardize industrial communication through a protocol capable of sending complex communications in a simple way, with a simpler configuration and faster messaging. The difference between Profibus DP and FMS is that with Profibus DP, the inputs and outputs, also called peripherals, of the instruments are not in the control room, but in the field. That is, they are decentralized, which reduces the necessary length of the cables to the instruments. Now, to communicate all this data to the control room, only one RS485 twisted pair cable is used. Then, Profibus PA, or Process Automation, was created, which can be intrinsically safe or explosion-proof. What differentiates it from Profibus DP is that all the cables that go to each of the instruments for their power supply and communication are done in just one, which saves even more on wiring. However, Profibus PA still relies on Profibus DP to communicate with the control room, as many devices do not have special inputs for Profibus PA, so a coupler must be used to be able to convert the Profibus PA signal to a Profibus DP signal. That's because the DP signal is faster. Both Profibus DP and Profibus PA work on RS485. The maximum transmission speed of Profibus DP is 12 megabits per second, while that of Profibus PA is 45.45 kilobits per second. Power cables must be used for DP instruments, while PA instruments get their power and exchange data through the same PA cable. Profibus PA needs a link or coupler to connect the DP network with the PA one, or vice versa. When using a coupler connected directly to the PA network, the transmission speed of the DP network will be reduced to 45.45 kilobits per second. In Profibus PA, the length of the cable and the current peaks must be taken into account. Current peaks, or surges, that appear transiently can affect the behavior of the network. Since the larger the trunk and the branches of the Profibus PA network, the greater the amplitude of transients due to the exposure to the difference of ground potential. For this, transient protectors are used, in which the limit voltage should not be much greater than the operational voltage of the equipment. In practice, it is common to use this voltage as twice the operating voltage of the equipment. These protectors must be carefully selected, because they can degrade the Profibus PA signal, and also limit the amount of equipment that can be connected. According to the manufacturer, this device can increase capacitance and resistance to the Profibus PA network, and this can affect the communication signal waveform. Also, some cutoff diodes may not be transparent to the network, and also affect signal levels. In practice, the user should look for devices that comply with this standard and offer high peak currents of around 10 kiloamperes at less than 40 farads to the wiring. Regarding the length of the wiring, If it is short, it can damage the equipment if its circuits and components are very sensitive. Since as the cable is twisted, the turns minimize the tension between the lines. Even so, the difference in ground potential can damage the cables, components and the behavior of the system by making it very sensitive. To avoid this, the use of shielding is recommended, which basically acts as a Faraday cage and maximizes its efficiency against noise. And well, this will be all for today's video. Don't forget to give me a like, subscribe and share. I upload videos every Wednesday in Spanish and every Friday in English. Adios! Current picks are... No. If I gotta go to rehab, I say no. I can try. Oh no. Profibus FMS. Para Dios.